In agriculture versus other industries, it's kind of confounding. If Ford and GM are competing to make the best car for the least amount of money, and one of them has a technological innovation that gives them an advantage, the other is scurrying rapidly to try and figure that out and one-up them and get back up on top. In farming, there's almost a blissful adherence to tradition, to want to do things the way grandpa did it. And that's not always a bad thing. There's good things that come out of that, but we need to understand science better as farmers. You know, when you're seeing yields start to go up and climb and do things that other people said were impossible, that's very gratifying. And I think a lot of our success in that area comes back to the way we've managed our soils and the way we've built our factory up to make it more productive. And so that's always gratifying. And sure, it's great to go out there after a big rainstorm in the springtime and see nothing but, see no water leaving your farm, or if there is water, it's clean water versus muddy avalanches next door. I mean, all those things matter. And you know, as you can tell, you know, one of our things that may set us apart a little too is we have a very long horizon for planning. I'm not looking at what's going to make me the most money next year or the year after. I'm looking at the next generation and 10 years down the line and trying to position for that. So, you know, when you see these things gradually move in this direction, it's something that's around you every day and you take pride in it.